Turn it on.
I'm working on it.
Yeah, none of those are on.
Everything else is on? I know we're a little late, but let's call this meeting in order. Has everybody registered to vote? It depends on voting today. Excellent. If you would, please silence all your cell phones and pagers so we're not getting calls in the middle of the meeting. And if that's all set, let's all stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Drummond Woodsum over in Lebanon. My role here is to give legal advice to the voters. I'm not here to express an opinion one way or the other. I'm not here to try to sway anyone. I'm just here to try to inform you all, the legislative body, about how I think your motions or your warrant articles would be interpreted under the law, and my effort is to be neutral in that respect.
Have you ever been
Yes, I attend between 5 to 10 a year for our various clients.
Has the town ever had a lawyer?
We're going to get to the rules here, but I think we're not going to cross-examine the lawyer right now.
This is my first time coming to Grafton. I'm glad to be here, though.
Okay, just let me elaborate why I mentioned
it. No, we're not going to discuss why we have a specific lawyer, Jay. All right, on the rules for today. I will read the number and text of the warrant article. I will call upon a sponsor to speak to the article. Once the sponsor or sponsors are done, there will be open discussion and or amendment. Primary and secondary motions. Motions for points of order, restricting reconsideration, can be made from the floor. I would ask, when you are going to make a second or call the question, that you actually raise your hand instead of yelling out that you second the motion. Amendments. Only one amendment will be considered at a time, and there must be a second to proceed. Amendments must be made in writing and presented to the moderator, who will read them and let the sponsor speak. All monetary amendments must be made in dollars and not percentages. Negative amendments will not be entertained. Amendments must include the original subject matter. Speaking articles. If you cannot speak loud enough, we'll try to help you or may add you to the front. Well, now we have microphones. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask everybody who wants to speak to anything, please line up in front of the microphone. Once we get to the point where someone wants to call a question, please let everybody in line speak because everybody should get their turn to speak. I will ask you if it seems like you're repeating yourself or you're droning on, I will ask you to wrap it up and to move along. Any inquiries or additional information will be made to the moderator who will determine who will respond. A motion to call the question and then we'll vote about that. And voting, once again, only registered voters of the town of Grafton may vote. When you vote, please hold your card over your head so the counters can easily determine your intention. And if the body feels a recount is warranted, a request shall be made for the card already by 7 registered and present voters. Does that make sense, everybody?
Yes.
Excellent. Let's move on to the warrant. Yes.
Are we not going to say the names of the Grafton residents who died or passed away, if you prefer, in the last year, like we did back in the more civilized days? It's good to remember people.
Thank you.
We do not have that information. And from now on, as you come up to the microphone, please say what your name is. That'd be most appreciated because we're taking minutes as we go. Okay. To the inhabitants of the town of Grafton and the county of Grafton, in said state of New Hampshire, qualified to vote in town affairs, you are hereby notified to meet at the Grafton Fire and Ambulance Station, Grafton, New Hampshire, on Saturday, the 10th of February, 2024, at 10 a.m. for the first session of the annual town meeting to discuss, debate, and amend the town budget and all warrant articles listed below, except Article Number 1, Election of Officers. You are hereby further notified to meet at the Grafton Fire and Ambulance Station, Grafton, New Hampshire, on Tuesday, the 12th of March, 2024, for the second session of the annual town meeting to vote by official ballot on elected officials and all warrant articles that are listed below. The polls will be open from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. Article Number 1, to choose all necessary officers for the coming year, including Selectmen, 3 years, Selectmen, 2 years, Budget Committee, 3 years, Trustee of the Trust Funds, 3 years, Library Trustee, 3 years, Cemetery Trustees, 3 years, Cemetery Trustees, 1 year, Planning Board, 3 years, Planning Board, 3 years, Treasurer, 3 years, Moderator, 2 years, Supervisor of the Checklist, 6 years. And on to Article Number 2. Shall the town raise and appropriate as an operating budget, not including appropriations by special warrant articles and other appropriations voted separately, the amount set forth on the budget posted with the warrant or amendment by the vote of the first session, for the purposes set forth, there are totally $1,345,651. Should this article be defeated, the default budget should be $1,365,593, which is the same as last year with certain adjustments required by previous actions of the town Grafton or by law, or the governing body may hold one special meeting in accordance with RSA 40:13X and XBI 15 to make up the issue of revised budget only. It includes special warrant articles and other appropriations voted separately. So before we begin, Budget Committee, would you like to speak for this?
No.
No? Select Board, would you like to speak to them?
Like an amendment for it, whatever you want to do that.
Okay, we can take that at any time. Just so we know, we're going to amend this, and Matt can help me out a little bit here, but we can amend the bottom line, we can go line by line, but there are certain things that cannot be amended if it is required by the state. So generally what happens is we do a modification to the bottom line with a recommendation that goes to a specific line item, but that is not necessarily held by the select board. We have to do that. So Leif, you've got an amendment?
Yeah. Do you need it?
Yes. I need it fully written out. No, I need it fully written out. Let's open up the floor for discussion at the budget board. Does anybody on the floor want to actually discuss this before we get the amendment? See, a first in draft this
year.
Mr. Darrell?
Yeah, we're talking about the amendment that the selectmen wish to make, mm-hmm. and you said you have to write it out. This is on Article 2. We have to write out the whole thing?
Well, what? Are you amending the bottom line?
It will be the bottom line.
Then you have to rewrite the first paragraph of it. That's what it's supposed to be. Am I correct on that one? That's exactly what it needs to be.
All verbiage after 2.
All verbiage after 2. You don't need all the numbers.
Just the number on the bottom. Okay. Rip
one off and scratch what you want to scratch in.
Point of order. If they're going to change the bottom line, we have to do it piece by piece.
No one's. So you make the motion that we want to go line by line, is that what you're saying, Brian?
If they're going to change...
Brian, if you're going to make the motion, you stand up at the microphone and raise your hand.
Alright. Brian Fellers, if we're going to adjust the numbers, why don't we do it line by line? We're not going to... We can have a big increase here in one of the numbers and have no reason to discuss it.
We will discuss it. Well, that's fine. You made a motion, you have a second.
He has to put that in writing.
What? Not a motion, but line by line.
Yes,
a
line.
Do we have a second to go line by line? Gary Whitten has a motion to go line by line. All right. The motion on the floor goes.
Last year we made a change in the bottom line.
I understand that, Pam. I really do. And that's why this is your option. Say yes or no, it's going line by line. So, anybody who wishes to talk about the budget on a line by line basis, please raise your cards to say yes. Four. All those who wish not to go line by line, please raise your cards.
Yeah. You guys can just take it.
22. The motion does not carry. We will not go line by line. Okay. I shall read it again. Shall the town raise and appropriate as an operating budget, not including appropriations by special warrant articles and other appropriations voted separately, the amount set forth on the budget posted with the warrant, or as amended by the vote of the first session for the purpose set forth therein for later. $1,355,651. Which is, should this article be defeated, the default budget shall be $1,365,593, which is the same as last year with certain adjustments required by previous actions of the town of Grafton by law, or the governing body will hold one special meeting in accordance with RSA 4013X and SBI. Take up the issue of revised budget only. It excludes special warrant articles and other appropriations for the sector. So, Lee, since you made this amendment, can we still speak to it and explain exactly what this purpose of this is? Oh, sorry. Did anybody second this? Do we have a second to this amendment?
I'll second.
So, we presented it.
Yes.
This is something that's been going on for 10 years, more years, and that is the utility companies are suing the town because we have evaluated their poles in the right ways, and they obviously don't want to pay it. This is a group action that suits. We're in the vote with 50 other towns, and we would have included this amount in the budget had we known it, but yesterday was the first day. My attention. This is the lawyers that are accompanying us are not our municipal attorney. It's a company called Sansui Associates. We have a number of 50 towns. We have advised each town to budget $10,000 to cover the legal fees. So that's what this is all about.
Any discussion from the floor?
Is this going to reduce
any
our
discussion from the floor? Please step up to the microphone.
Are all these lawyers battling what telephone poles were? Is that going to reduce our taxes? The city of Bow just lost $100 million battling the same type lawsuit. And guess who paid for it?
The taxpayers usually pay.
Higher than the proposed budget. The default budget is higher than the proposed budget.
wish to call the question?
So we'll...
I can't make motions. You make the motions?
I made the motion.
Okay, do we have a second?
Second.
Lee seconded. All right, all those in favor of the amendment, do I need to read it again by raising $10,000? You're going to save me my COP. All right, all in favor of the amendment, as Lee has stated, please raise your cards as a yes.
I would department got reserve funds. has $147,382.87.
There was a definite plan, we actually use this money from the near future, we don't have any idea what is going on. This will be used for. There's some things that they need to be done.
There's no main act that we've done, it's not have to be done.
What were previous purchases done from the money taken out of that account in the tax?
Peter, do you have?
What were previous purchases that were made done in those funds in the tax?
CD. CD. The small truck.
Yeah.
Was the last thing that was purchased out of that capital reserve.
So I got TV, the new ball truck.
Was that the replacement truck?
Huh?
Is it a replacement truck?
The original truck before it crashed.
All right.
Any other discussion? All right, we have no amendments. Move on to argument number four. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate its own $75,000 for the purpose of paving town roads. The selectmen recommend this article, the budget committee recommends this article. Select board?
So it takes a lot of money to pave at least a mile. And this is just to cover some of the tar roads that are being abused and have been taken care of the last some of years. That's all it is.
There we go. What did you make? Any heads?
Yes.
Good.
Good. Just so people understand, when they say a mile of pavement, that doesn't mean one straight mile. That means a half a mile one way and a half a mile that. So that's only covering a half a mile of that. Okay. Reason it's on the warrant is in previous years, it was in the budget. Once it goes in the budget, it could be spent for anything. So by being on the warrant, that means that money can only be spent for pay, can't be spent for anything else.
Careful. And I know last year we voted 40,000 and it didn't get spent, correct? And I have heard rumors, and you guys can straighten me out, that they want to pave turnpike down to the bridge at the corner of Millbrook.
No.
That's where I heard rumors of. No truth to those rumors?
I don't know of any plan to pay any road that is not paid.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Cindy Cutler. It was $60,000 that we appropriated for paving last year, and not any of that got spent. Is that correct? And also, was that money then encumbered?
No. None was spent. It was going into the general fund.
For one, can we get a clarification if the money is intended to use for paving the new roads or for maintaining existing ones? And second, the road agent had a select committee to say that was an intention, so not a road.
Any further discussion? Said that they are not aware of the plan.
No. Is it paving new roads or maintaining existing ones?
It's all spent paving existing roads.
The article used to say to repave existing paved roads. The language was taken out, so it just says paving roads And like I said before, I have a little plan and to pay unpaid roads. The cost of that is far more expensive than to just cover to repay paved roads. So, you know, if you heard that we'll be paid down to the Millbrook Road, that's the first time I've heard of it, so I agree with that.
Ed?
When the road agent came in front of the budget committee, he did say what Jay was saying. He was looking at doing paving some unpaved roads. We asked the select board. Select board said that they were not aware of that.
My budget number one.
So technically, to pave that road would be more than a one-year project. Because you had to tear up tar, level the road, let it set a year, then pave it a year after. So this would not be for a whole new paving project of a dirt road or completion of a tar road.
Any further discussion?
All right. I've got item number five. See if the town will vote to raise and appropriate some $50,000 to replace the previously established bridge capital reserve fund. This sum comes from the unassigned fund balance. No amount to be raised from additional taxation. The select recommend this article. The budget committee recommends this article. Select board.
Justin, since we're trying to avoid losing another bridge, we all remember Prescott Hill's bridge going. That one was $100,000+. This is just a proceed that.
Was the budget committee's vote unanimous?
Yes. They asked the budget committee to vote unanimous. The budget committee said yes. Any further discussion? On to article number six. See if the town will vote to raise and appropriate sum of $15,000 to replace in the previously established town hall repairs capital reserve fund. The select board recommends this article. The budget committee recommends this article. Select board.
These are all very much the same. Town hall being old, plenty of love work. This is just to keep it up and running.
What do you think? Any discussion from the floor? All right, on topic number seven. See if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $15,000 to replace the previously established property tax reevaluation capital reserve fund. The select board recommends this article. The budget committee recommends this article. Select board.
So I just think every 5 years we have to do a reval. Next year it comes up, and then we get a big bill from Altar for the whole year to keep out. We've been doing this since time to sell. Just so we don't get a full bill, one huge bill at once. We're taking a $15,000 hit instead of a $75,000 hit.
Up to the length of the line. Budget committee, anything?
No.
The town doesn't have to reevaluate every 5 years. That's false. It says shall. It does not say must. Forcing us to pay a corporate entity to tell us what our property is worth is expensive.
cycle is 5 years, and we do the statistical update. In the meantime, everybody's house gets remeasured to make sure that the, hopefully that all the measurements are accurate. And we have, in the past, about 20 years ago, been ordered by the state to do a reappraisal. And that's a position we really don't want to put the town in, because it's going to end up costing us a lot more money if we go that route.
So, warrant Article 5, was it unanimous?
Oh, warrant Article 5, not the warrant Article 5.
There was no motion to close discussion. So.
There was no limit.
Understood, but we're still on Article 6.
It doesn't matter, there was no
is this your meeting, Jake?
Where is that? Yeah,
that's done, and now we're regressing as we finish with 6.
All right, so after 6, I'm going to go.
I will give you a chance after we finish with 6.
My understanding is there isn't really a must. It's either may or shall. Shall is must. Same thing. The other thing is, let's not forget that if everybody's property is assessed at the same rate and our budget stays the same, it's chopped up and your tax bill is going to be the same.
I appreciate you saying that, because if everybody has been noticing this, it's kind of been a sign. When properties selling for these days, we're going to have a revaluation next year, and I would assume that all our properties are going to be appraised or assessed at far more than they are now. And when that happens, everything's being equal, it's divided up the same way, so it should not have any effect on taxation unless we spend more in this meeting.
Any further discussion on Article 6? Seven. Jake, you wanted to ask a question on Article 5?
Yes. Well, was the budget committee vote unanimous?
It was not.
It was not. Okay. So those who voted against it from year one.
So you're asking to change that again because we opposed it. So my reason for opposing it is because I thought the budget is giving way out of hand. And I thought we could stay here.
Thank you.
So Article 5?
Sure, yeah. I'd like to make a motion to open under consideration Article 3 and 6.
Has everybody done discussing Article number 5 before we
accept? No.
One more thing.
Okay. Article number 5.
So Article number 5 does not come from taxation. Not this year. It came from previous years. So skipping a year, not skipping a year. You're not saving money. You're not losing money. You're saving the bridge.
All right. Then we have a motion on the floor. Preliminary consideration on Articles 3 through 7. We have a second.
Second.
Third.
Your name is?
Amelia, sorry.
Oh, Amelia.
You're looking at me.
Okay, all in favor of limiting reconsideration on Articles 3 through 7, please raise your hands and say yes. Carries. Budget Committee recommends this article. Select Board?
Come on, this one, Steve. Fire apparatus.
Well, once again, we have reserve funds to add onto our fire apparatus, and Lee mentioned before, how much it costs to get a grader. Well, all our fire apparatus are similar cost, so this is just $10,000, which in the scheme of things is a modest fund to add to the savings account. Should we replace one of our apparatus?
What's your name?
Chief.
Mr. McDowell.
I mentioned McDowell. I've been checking the fire apparatus just in case we ever had a serious accident with one of them. The average fire truck, exactly like the one we got now, is $650,000. We've been putting money in the capital reserve fund since 2004. And we still don't have enough to buy a fire truck. We should lose a truck. We're out of the fire business. And it's a scary thought, because if you have to buy a new truck, you're going to spend $250,000 in 5 years. Be able to use it because he has the estate in front of him. I think we need to up this fund for at least 20,000, and it should be more than 20, would be better than 10. The average price of a fire truck right now is up around $30,000 a year increase in price. So next year, $650,000 price is going to be almost $700,000.
So are you wanting to make an amendment to this?
I'd like to make an amendment to it.
Can you write that out for us, please?
Yeah.
You can just tear it off and scratch and make it whatever number you want to, and we'll tell you why.
Cindy, I'm just curious if someone from the Select Board or the Budget Committee can tell us why it was dropped down to 10,000. We did 40,000 last year, and Buddy and Roger had a plan, and I'm wondering why they think that sounds better this year.
Ed, that's what was submitted to the Budget Committee, was the 10,000. So we can't raise a lower.
We have amendments to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $20,000 in the previously established fire department apparatus capital reserve funds. Everybody's already spoken to it. Do we have any further discussion on this?
Second.
Oh, sorry.
Rick Feinberg.
Rick Feinberg, second. Any further discussion? $20,000. We raised $10,000 to $20,000. All right. So the motion is to increase it to $20,000. Anybody who approves and says yes to the amended version of this article, please raise your cards. Select Board?
The capital reserve fund is a, our recycling center is built on top of a landfill, and most of the landfills have been ordered by the state to seal them, which means they have to have an impervious surface put on the surface on top of them. What happened, a decade or so ago is the state changed the rules so that small towns, less than 5,000, would not have to seal their landfills, provided that the town puts in monitoring wells. So what we have happening now is we have an engineering company coming, I think it's twice a year, it used to be four times a year, and we have four wells down there, and they test them, and they see if there's anything happening. A few years ago, they found some PFAS down there. We had to go around and test all the neighboring wells to make sure that there were no PFAS in those wells, and thank goodness they found none. So we were able to continue, but what this fund is for, and you never know what's going to happen, is that the state could come up and say, well, in light of all the contamination that's going around the state, we're going to order that all landfills be sealed. And at that point, we'll be stuck with a large bill, so we're just trying to have some money in reserve so we can do that should that arise.
Do you mean to tell us that the state lied to us and reneged on a contract, and now we have to have wasted money put aside when they changed the contract that we voted for 10 years ago? And now we need more money to build up for when they change the rules again and lie to us again? I'm just putting it in English.
I know. You never know when the rules and regulations change, and they
will decay
at some point.
Karen Myers, you have more science, you get more research, you get new information that you need to preserve health. That's not lying originally, that's change according to the needs of health of the public.
Is there a rough estimation for a project? Is this a rough estimation for the cost of such a project?
Not at this time.
Anything further? All right. We shall move on to article number 10. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate sum of $5,000 to replace the previously established Veterans Park Capital Reserve Fund. Select Committee and Budget Committee recommend this article. Select Board.
So this fund so far has caught the new monument, taking down the old bed tree and put up a smaller new tree. We're planning on taking down the other maples and replacing them are your better trees. And this will help us do that and anything else we want to do. Pretty much the first thing people see driving into this town.
Yeah, the trees, just so people know, are being donated by the Williams family. So the trees are no cost to the town. It's just getting Fox trees to come in and remove what trees are there, and so that we could have a really nice looking common when they get done.
Any discussion from the board?
All right, rule one. Article number 11. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $5,000 to be placed in the previously established Historical Records Restoration Capital Reserve Fund. Select Board recommends this article. The Budget Committee recommends this article. Select Board.
Do this every year. This is historic old books. If you want to know more about price on books and how many you can do a year.
So to get to that, it costs about $2,000. We don't get very far. I have still about 42
see if the town will vote to appropriate the board of selectmen as agents to expend from the highway department capital reserve fund previously established in 1969. Select board.
So most of these calls for 17 were cleared for 1 point that right now these do not have meetings to expend. So if something happens in July, we lose a truck, lose his equipment, we can actually get it replaced doing a special meeting, which costs the town money. We can get it replaced. Like the CV, we're lucky that it was insurance covered and we took it from other parts of our budget. If there were places we couldn't, we wouldn't have that truck right now.
Dr. Mudge,
is this a permanent change? Because in the past, it was a two-thirds vote to allow, I believe it was a two-thirds vote to allow the selectmen to be agents to expand the capital reserve.
This is a permanent.
And it doesn't take two-thirds?
No.
I'm not a lawyer. I'm looking for some help from the town paid lawyer over there.
That is free from the DRA.
I do believe this is correct on this particular instance of it.
There you go. The only reason you need two-thirds is if you're repurposing the article. This is for the same purpose, just giving the selectmen's permission to expend from it at any time during the year. And the trustees of the trust fund, which I am a member of, also oversee it so that it's spent correctly.
Anyone else? Okay, we'll Article number 13, to see if the town will vote to appoint the board of selectmen as agents to expend from the ambulance capital reserve fund previously established in 1999. Do you want to speak to this again?
I'll speak to them in general. What we're asking in a series of articles is to give the selectmen the latitude to be able to spend when we have to spend. If an emergency happens in any of these areas, then we can't spend it. We have to call a special town meeting in order to get permission. This gives the selectmen to operate as a governing body and to spend the money as needed. If the voters feel that the selectmen are being frivolous and not doing what they should, the remedy for that is to hold them out of office. But while they're in office, they have to have the ability to manage and operate the town.
Alright, Article number 14. To see if the town will vote to appoint the Board of Selectmen as agent to expend from the Police Cruiser Capital Reserve Fund previously established in 1999. I'm assuming all the arguments remain the same. Any discussion from the floor? Article 15. To see if the town will vote to appoint the Board of Selectmen as agent to expend from the Fire Department Apparatus Capital Reserve Fund previously established in 2003. Discussion anywhere? Article number 16, to see if the town will vote to appoint Board of Selectmen as agent to expend from the Roll-Off Truck Capital Reserve Fund previously established in 2017. Discussion? This is kind of amazing. To see if the town will vote to appoint the Board of Selectmen as agent to expend from the Bridge Capital Reserve Fund previously established in 1982. Any discussion? Okay. Cards.